Friends, this is Pete, K7PP, with another video. I'm working with another ham here, trying to come up with a understanding of what each of us is talking about, and perhaps understand what's happening to a piece of equipment. So I'm going to look at a piece of ICOM equipment here, and look at a marker signal on the radio, and look at sideband suppression. I'm not going to make any measurements per se, but just look at the tuning and see what happens when we tune through the passband. Now right now we're at 3900 kilocycles, and as we tune the lower sideband, you'll notice the S meter. I'll see if I can get everything in here at the same time. And we have a 10 over 9 signal. And signal's pretty consistent to just a little over 3 kilohertz before it goes away. And then a zero beat. And now we're going to tune the upper sideband. Basically nothing detectable at all, thanks to the marvel of crystal filters. And again, our lower sideband. Switching to upper sideband. Nothing, nothing. And we're basically getting the reverse to about 3 kilohertz before the signal disappears. Okay, now I'd call this normal for a crystal filter rig, definitely, and not bad performance at that. So now let's take a look at a vacuum tube, an older rig, and we're looking at a different type of sideband suppression system using switched capacitors and shifting the IF, the lower IF frequency slightly, and see what we get, see what kind of performance we get. Okay, we're doing the same thing with a Hammarlund HQ170 Alpha, and I'm actually going to do this with several receivers just to see if they all exhibit the same kind of phenomena. But there is nowhere the sharpness in these older receivers than there are with the newer rigs with the crystal filters, or even some of the really old Collins gear that uses mechanical or crystal filters, far superior. So there's less sideband suppression, and it actually appears as if there is some opposite sideband detection capabilities, even if you're tuning the opposite sideband. So let's take a look here. Again, a marker generator, and I've set the signal for 10 over 9, just like the other receiver. And we're in lower sideband. And there's the lower sideband passband to about 3 kilohertz, then it goes away. And there's our 10 over 9 all the way down to zero beat. And then what appears to be a very gradual drop off at about 1,000 hertz, give or take, before it actually goes away. So there is a response on the upper sideband in this type of filter. I'm going to switch to upper sideband now, and going back the other way, starts at about 3,000 to the zero beat, and then gradually goes away as we tune the upper sideband. So nowhere near as good as the again as the modern equipment, but if you're on a crowded band, this receiver is not going to perform as well as one that excludes most of the opposite sideband. So let's switch over to another receiver and just double check it. By the way, this particular one is fairly symmetrical. Of course, we knew that going in because the S meter at center frequency reads pretty much the same between upper and lower sideband. So both the sidebands are pretty well balanced. What isn't balanced is how well they actually reject the opposite sideband. Okay, let's look at the other receiver. Okay, now we're across the room with the other Hammarlund HQ170 Alpha, and we're going to run the same test. I've set the calibrator on and adjusted the RF gain control for 10 dB over S9, and we're going to go through the passband and see how she works. Okay, this is the lower sideband. There's our 10 over 9, 0 beat. And things kind of taper off quickly. And going back to upper sideband. So the other sideband is there, but is extremely narrow, as it deteriorates in performance. And again, like the other receiver, it's balanced on both sides. I could make the same test on the other receivers, but they'll be the same. So, are we talking the same thing, Kim? Are we looking at even worse performance than that? Or is your receiver doing the same thing these ones are? I'm dying to know. Hope this helps. And if we still have a problem, then we'll start looking at some other things to troubleshoot. Good luck. I got my fingers crossed for you. This is Pete, K7PP.